Valdez or the Marcos administration to dismantle or put down the third administration, also the previous Duterte administration?
I don't think there is such a plan to put down the Duterte. I don't think it's in anybody's plan to put down people. I don't think, honestly, I don't even want to answer the question. What we're trying to do is we're wanting to provide better services and better governance for the people. Unfortunately, there are issues where we need to really stand for. There are issues that need to be clarified. There are issues that need to be pursued. So I think it is not to the detriment of one family or one political camp. We are simply doing our job.
Sir, sinasabi, naging meticuloso ang Kongreso sa pagbusisi dun sa budget ng OPP, pero dun sa budget, proposed budget para sa Office of the President ay parang walang ginawang mga pag-usisa.
You know, these budgets are being shared with us ahead of time. In most cases, no, we are able to study this before they are even discussed in plenary or in committee. So sometimes when a presentation is made, we already have a fair understanding. And siguro po, just to satisfy everyone who have the same thing in mind, that is where trust is a factor. Diba? Obviously, with the president, he enjoys the trust of majority of the members of Congress, that we are willing to provide the support needed for him to be able to carry out the mandate of his office. Well, for the vice president, the same thing. As I've mentioned in many interviews, I've said that we are willing to support whatever the vice president needs to carry out the constitutional mandate. And that is as constitutional successor to the sitting president. Now, over and above that, have to be explained. In such case, that the vice president has refused to explain.
Pero there are chances, sir, the plenary will adopt the report of the committee in the budget slashing of the vice president.
We will wait. I don't want to preempt how the debates will be. The vice president has allies in the House. Maybe they'll be able to give us a fair and better understanding and appreciation of how the budget of the vice president is appreciated. We have the opposition to also review that. But nonetheless, it's not yet a done deal. That is for sure. Aside from the House, that would be sent to the Senate, and you have a number of senators already expressing that they will restore or they will keep the original values, amounts that were proposed by the Office of the President, Vice President, and we see no problem with it because that's how the system is. And then there will be a bicam. We can only, this is the thing, and I was talking to the sponsor of the budget of the Vice President. We can only work with the information that we have. But we cannot fill in the blanks for their office. And the thing is, like, this is the thing that I would also emphasize. When the executive, when Congress sits to review the budget, and the executive comes to present the budget, it's not a mere technical presentation. It's really, I like to use the word intellectual. They come, even if they don't need to explain, even if you already know it's needed, they just go through the process. Why? Because that is the only time when Congress exercises the so-called power of the purse. It is the only time that we can put our seal of approval, because we cannot impose ourselves on the executive. There is what you call separation of powers. We are co-equal branches. We cannot tell them what to do. But we can stamp our approval by the amount of resources that we are able to allocate for every agency. Now, that is not something that should be taken lightly. And that's why many of people in Congress, we feel bad that the Vice President decided not to appear. Or in the case of the first hearing, that the Vice President has chosen not to answer the question.
Behind the scene, nag-uusap pa kayo? Behind the scene na? Meron bang pagkataon na nag-uusap kayo? Or open communication pa kayo?
With the Office of the Vice President? I think the committee and the sponsor are all reaching out. I understand the sponsor, Congressman Sia, has reached out to the Office of the Vice President. And they're working on how to defend the budget at the plenary, I suppose. I can't say as to the extent of their discussions, but I've seen Kongzilla diligently work to get all the information needed to defend the budget of the Office of the Vice President.
Nag-iose na ba yan ang proposal extension ng term ng mga
panalo? The bill has been filed but has not been discussed.
So 5 years na.
So the proposal is 6 years, but probably we'll be able to jumpstart discussions as soon as we're done with the budget deliberations.
Datang po the Vice President, sir, question why you deal with so many offices and yet not a budget or sa Pilipinas?
Because we don't use government funds for any offices. We don't use government funds to pay for the staff. These are being funded, these are being operated by partners, by supporters, by party officials. We have our own way of convincing people to support the work we do. We have district congressmen who believe in what we do. So that's how we are able to roll out everything. And the second thing is, unlike the Office of the Vice President, Tingog does not have standalone funds. That's why when you go to Tingog office, you don't get, as you said, here and there. Kato ka, dadalun ka, SWD. Kato ka, dadalun ni one voucher, get to a hospital. We cannot handle because we do not have custody of the funds. And that is the thing that the people have to understand with the Office of the Vice President. The Office of the Vice President wants to have their own funds. They want to have their own medical assistance. They want to have their own. And the problem is, based on their utilization as of last year, it was very inefficient. That was surplus. So the understanding of congressmen and the members of the committee is that why do we have to give exemption to the Office of the Vice President when everybody, from the President to everyone, uses the same government facilities, same government programs that we have, diba? That way, we do not have to duplicate. That way, we make spending more efficient. So those are the two things. The OVP, all the 12 offices are funded by government funds. All are paid for by government. Hati mo, piri, waray, diba? All of these are funded privately, funded by supporters, funded by our officers, diba? Because also, we only need 3 people every center. Two or three people. It's not the same extent as what we need. And the second is the differences in the funds that they are handling. Well, the thing is, we don't have custody of any funds. That's in the agencies. We only refer, we only tell them these are the requirements, you complete this, this is the process, and they facilitate. And the Office of the Vice President needs something else. They want their own fund, they have full control, and they don't have to work with the SWD, they set their own guidelines, things like that.
So, according to Senator Joel Villanueva, I'm sharing ako ng harsh plenary kung tap masyadong budget and vice president.
Well, that's the statement of Senator Villanueva. If you ask me, the House has been very, very, very patient. And I think the fact that it's still a substantial amount of 700 million, it's the same amount as the former Vice President, Leni Robredo, that she had during her last year in office. So if VP Leni was able to carry out her functions with that amount, then we see no reason why the sitting Vice President can.
Your comment, na itong buwata kung House of Representatives controlled by House Speaker from office.
I hope we all are familiar. She's a lawyer. This is the frustrating part. She should know the process of the budget, diba? The budget, the executive prepares the national expenditure program, then sends it to the House deliberates on it, develops the general appropriations bill, of course the chairman of appropriations there. We do the hearings in committee, we do the hearings in plenary. After that, we send it to the Senate. And then the Senate does the same process, deliberates on committee, deliberates in plenary. Then if there are differences, we work it out with a bicameral committee. And it goes back to both houses for ratification. If they agree what the decision of the bicam was, then present it to the president for the signature. At which point the president even can veto line items. And then in in actualizing the budget, in the implementation of the budget, Congress has no more hand. It's all in the executive. So the executive is the one who controls the disbursement. It's all DBM, it's all the agencies. So it's very unfair for the vice president to impute that the speaker has the sole control, di ba? Sering kanina mon, unfortunately, what she was talking about, the classroom, no? Kung kamaaro hit mga congressman, kung may control ito yung speaker o yung chairman Saldico, di rin na dapat 3% ng utilization nito. But I will give you the inside story because, anyway, paborito ko kang Mary Jo Nito. She mentioned that the original budget was 5 million and became 10 million. Di ba? Okay, this is what happened. She proposed 5 million. She didn't have a list. It was a lump sum request. So we don't know where she will put the classrooms. So, of course, this is the reality. When the budget goes through the House, we also try to represent our districts well and making sure that the requirements in our respective districts and constituencies are addressed. Diba? That's what we got elected for. Diba? So, in the interest of realizing that particular goal, Congress said, okay, we will not touch the president, the vice president's 5% of 5 billion. We will not touch the 5 billion of the vice president. But we will come up with a list, proposals. And that was submitted per item. Per district got an equitable share of classrooms in the 10 million that was added. We did not take anything from her. Yeah? Only the 10 million, kini man niya, lang sama na to, iya man, kami, namili kaming paagi nga, mapunduhan ang amon mga classrooms were all submitted per item. In fact, if you ask me, Congress did the far better way. Because what Congress did was to ensure that all districts will have the some di man na tanan, mga idala, 30 million worth of that classroom kada distrito. Kaya di man masugod ito ibang itibawaray. Which the office of the secretary then, VP Sara, would not guarantee. Kaya may dahira, plano for the report. So that's how we work, di ba? We do not try to impose ourselves on the agency, but we find ways of complementing. In fact, I was saying, yan na pala kung hindi ka ng pondo, yan at nareklamo. So her request for 5 million was granted. In addition, congressmen identified classroom buildings and funded per item, diri lang sama, per item. And that's how we ended up with the 15 million. Now, our challenge is this. She was the one who said, give me 100 billion and I will solve the classroom shortage in the country. They only gave her 15 billion, she complains, di ba? And ending, 3% utilization lang.